Did you know your brain is the world's greatest computer? That's because, among other things, the brain works as a massive network. All of the neurons connect and branch off of each other, creating a system where all our memories and the information we gain are stored.
A mind map looks suspiciously like a brain network. This isn't a coincidence. Mind maps literally model the way you think. They're tools to help you expand your thoughts from a single topic into a web of connected ideas. We start by taking a main topic from which we'll branch off. And this can be anything, a question, a class, a name, an idea, whatever helps you get the ball going. From this topic, we expand out, building connections with whatever we associate with that topic. When you're making a mind map, you're not just filling in information. Your brain is hard at work as you do this. You're actually building connections between the topics so that when you return to your mind map, those established connections are triggered, helping you pay attention, think, learn, and remember better. It's like your own personal cheat sheet. Before we continue, let's just emphasize this. Mind maps are creative. Mind maps are freeform. Mind maps are messy, and that's beautiful. When we use our brains, we're not thinking in paragraphs or conversations. We think in images, phrases, questions, and ideas. This can translate over to how our mind maps look. The best part about mind maps, they're easy to make. Let's show you what we mean by making our own in Lucidchart. To get started on making a mind map from scratch, open a blank document from the dashboard. Lucidchart already comes with tools specifically built for making mind maps. To get those to appear in our toolbox, click on Shapes and scroll down to check the mind map box. Now we have mind map shapes in the left toolbox and an additional toolbar. For this mind map, let's pick natural disasters as our main topic. To get started, drag a shape from the mind map library and drop it onto the canvas. Double-click inside the shapes to add text. Now that we have our main topic, which is sometimes called a parent, we're going to build off of it. When we're ready, hover the cursor over the shape and make these red dots appear. Click and drag away from them. When you release, you'll be prompted to pick another shape. We can branch off the main topic as many times as we believe we need to. To help us learn about natural disasters, we can categorize our associated topics however we like. We sometimes call them children because they come from a parent idea. With these topics, we can create new associations around them. This time, we can categorize them by type, region, or how they're created, or the types of damage they inflict, or how cool they look, or how scary, or a bunch of fun facts, or which one we like the most. The point is, it's endless how we can go off of these topics. A useful trick for understanding how to categorize your mind map is to honestly go with the flow and trust how your brain thinks everything should be organized. And if you make a mistake, don't worry, that's natural. Lucidchart makes it easy to clean it up. Just reconnect your information to its new place. Here are some extra hints for making effective mind maps in Lucidchart. We can use this advanced options bar to change colors, thus labeling the different generations of children. Using different colors is a great way to organize and help your brain navigate through your mind map. In the properties bar above it, we can do a lot more than change colors. We can customize our font, size, and style, among other things. Clicking on this icon on a mind map will collapse all the shapes it's a parent to. Speaking of parents and children, using the tab and enter keys, we can create new parents or sibling ideas easily. After typing into a shape, hit enter. If you want to make another sibling idea, press enter. If you'd like to make a new child, hit tap. To discover what keyboard shortcuts you can use for mind maps, go to the hotkey reference under help. By this point, you realize how awesome mind maps are. They're not just a great tool for school, they're a great tool for life. And building them in Lucidchart has never been easier.